So this is exciting, doing an interview in a bar.
Yeah.
Kent Alterman, thank you so much for joining us today. For those who don't know, what is the Colossal Clusterfest?
Colossal Clusterfest is Comedy Central's first immersive, comedy-driven festival. It will take place over 3 days here in San Francisco. And we felt like there was nothing like this that existed. Right now we're at a recreation of Patty's Pub, and this is the pub and the set from It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia, and it is an exact replica of the set. And it's one of three immersive experiences that we have at the festival. So there's this one, there's a South Park activation that's outside, and it basically captures 14 seminal moments from the history of South Park. And then we also have a recreation of Jerry Seinfeld's apartment from the show, and a lot of food that's related thematically to that show as well.
What are the highlights this weekend?
There's an incredible mix of both stand-up comedians from really established stars, you know, like Jerry Seinfeld and Kevin Hart, Sarah Silverman, and it's a mix of people that you would be aware of, but also sort of emerging talent. And then also we have a mix, not just stand-up, but different genres. So we have sketch comedy, improv, we have podcasting here, and then we also have music as well.
Comedy has been tackling controversial issues such as race and politics for a long time. What do you think is the role of comedy today in tackling racism and challenging people's stereotypes or perceptions?
Good comedy has always been an essential part of society, and it's one of the most pure, unfiltered ways that society has to reflect back on itself. So I think comedy has always served a very important purpose in our society through the ages, and it goes all the way back to, you know, the court jester who was the only person who had permission to speak truth to the king. And with that freedom, you know, comes knowledge. And so I think that no matter what time you're living in, the best comedy and the comedy that really rises above and elevates is comedy that has a very strong point of view and something to say. And I think the times we're living in, it just continues to heighten, you know, the importance of comedy in our culture.
Do you think that comedians still have a responsibility to know when a joke has gone too far or when they've crossed the line?
Well, I think it's a very delicate equation. And I think that no comedian will ever know when they cross the line until they cross it, until they get close to it. And I think that part of the social contract that we have with comedians is, I believe that they should have a very unfiltered point of view. And I think the good comedians are very savvy about that, because their intention isn't about offending people. Their intention is to try to really go at some truth. It goes all the way back to our own families when you grow up. You know, comedy can be born of saying the thing that no one is comfortable enough to, you know, the unspoken thing at the dinner table. And why do we laugh? We're breaking the tension. I mean, that's the essence of what comedy is. So to me, by nature, good comedy often is controversial, because it's tapping into potentially uncomfortable truth, whether it's social, cultural, racial, political.
For those who don't know, Colossal Clusterfest is only going to be performed in San Francisco. Why did you choose San Francisco as the venue instead of New York or LA?
We started looking at different places around the country, back east and the south. We kind of went all over, and we pretty quickly settled on San Francisco as a great opportunity. And we feel like it really combines the great comedy tradition. You know, Robin Williams and many others have come through here that have made it really big. And then there's all the history of, you know, the Bill Graham Auditorium. We didn't know when we set out that we would be lucky enough to get this kind of a venue. And the plaza outside, it's an incredible environment and location. And once all that came together, we realized that we struck pay dirt.
I'd be remiss if I didn't ask you, what is your favorite Seinfeld episode?
That is a tough question, because there's obviously so many great ones, but one that has a special place in my heart is the Soup Nazi episode.
You didn't get any bread.
Just forget it, let it go.
When I worked on TV Nation, our office was very near the Soup Nazi kitchen when it first opened.
What? No soup for you!
He was very intense about how you ordered and where you stood and if you kept things moving, and he would refuse service to people who didn't get with the program, and conversely, he would reward people who were really on top of it with extra food. And we used to have a competition, the writers and I, at TV Nation, to see who could come back with the biggest bounty.
And people can test their luck with the Soup Nazi, because he's going to be here this weekend, right?
Correct, yes. The Soup Nazi will be here, and he'll be happily insulting anyone who comes by.
Kent, Thanks so much for taking time to talk with us.
Thank you for having me.